Hey everybody, welcome back to another reaction video. This one is Rue Bennett, I Hate Myself, and it's from the show Euphoria. I've never actually seen the show, I've heard about it. It was everywhere for a hot second. I grabbed this one right out of the comments, link in the description for the Patreon. Leave a like in the video if you like it, subscribe to the channel. If you're new here, hit that notification bell, that way you know when videos post. You can come check them out immediately, and let's go. Since I don't know much about the show, I'm actually going to look up what exactly it's about. Apparently it's an adaptation of an Israeli show of the same name, which is hit or miss. Skins UK was amazing. I saw all the episodes. I think I watched through it maybe 2-3 times. I'd watch through it again right now. Then MTV made a US version of Skins, and it was atrocious. It was so bad. Sometimes it goes one way, sometimes it goes the other. The UK office, pretty good. US office, pretty amazing. So sometimes it's hit or miss with those remakes. All right, Euphoria follows a group of high school students as they navigate love and friendships in a world of drugs, sex, trauma, and social media. Boy, that sounds like Skins, doesn't it?
A memory?
Anything that had an impact on you this summer.
I can't think of... I'm having trouble, remembering something, you know.
Just tell us a specific memory.
I was with my mom and my little sister, and we were listening to this song.
Hey, I'm Rue. I'm an addict. Like
I was once happy, content.
I'm very happy for you, Rue.
New chapter.
Mom. And Gia.
Gia, who absolutely idolizes you.
I know, Mom.
Rue,
to have her find you unconscious. And I know it all may seem sad, but guess what? I didn't build this system. Nor did I fuck it up.
Yeah.
I don't remember much between the ages of 8 and 12. Just that the world moved fast and my brain moved slow. And every now and then, if I focus too closely on the way I breathe, I die. Until every second of every day, you find yourself trying to outrun your anxiety. And quite frankly, I'm just fucking exhausted.
Okay. So Skins was a little bit more upbeat. This is more like Rue has a serious problem here. Getting help. Have a lot of issues. Not fully there yet. Skins was way more party scene in the midst of just screwing around, taking whatever. Very different reality.
I know a lot of you probably hate me right now. And I get it. If I could be a different person, I promise you, I would. I'm not kidding you. Not because I want it.
I'm not trying to become best friends with someone who's gonna fucking kill himself.
But because they do. And therein lies the catch.
The hardest part has been feeling like I owe it to myself.
I don't know what type of fucked up shit you got going inside your head. I don't know how to help, but I can tell you one thing, the drug shit is not the answer.
All of a sudden I couldn't breathe. I was like, there's no more air left.
Wow. I was gasping.
This is it.
like I should.
I don't want you to fucking check on me, whether I'm fine or I'm not fine. What difference are you going to make?
This is the feeling I've been searching for my entire life, for as long as I can remember, because suddenly,
oh my God,
and I felt safe in my own head.
But when she wakes up, she'll be given the opportunity to get clean, to become a different person, a better person. Here's the toughest part. No matter what you say or do or wish, the decision will be all hers. And all you can do is hope.
It's true.
She gives herself the chance she deserves. Keep speaking to me, but I can't
have it. The other thing about depression is it kind of collapses time. Suddenly, you find your whole days blending together to create one endless and suffocating loop. So you find yourself trying to remember the things that made you happy. But slowly, your brain begins to erase every memory that ever brought you joy. And eventually, all you can think about is how life has always been this way. And it will only continue to be this way.
I'm a burden, and it is what it is, and it's embarrassing and it's stupid, but it's true. So, I'm sorry.
The absolute worst part of depression is that even though you know you're depressed, you're unable to stop yourself from getting worse.
Okay. Wow. That was deep and powerful and really sad. Link down below in the description. Go throw it some well-deserved love. So that is not exactly how I envisioned that going. I was assuming it was going to be a little bit more party scene. I thought it was going to be more before the crash. That's typically how a lot of these shows go. It's very rare that you see a show that shows the ugly aftermath of anxiety attacks and depression, trying to get better, going into substance abuse programs, that fight, that clawing their way back into normalcy. That is really dark. But it is good that it's being shown. I'm assuming that's just one aspect of the show, and there's probably a lot of party scenes as well. Boy, that really just brought me down. I'm laughing because I'm realizing how sad that was and how I was not prepared for that at all. I know a lot of people were talking about the show. It was definitely hot, super hot when it came out. Did you like the show? Did you love it? Did you hate it? What about it would you change? Was there too much of one thing? Did you relate to it at all? I mean, there's got to be some relation there. It caught fire with a lot of people, so there's got to be some relatability to it. I'm assuming it's whether it's a relative or a friend or maybe yourself that's going through something similar. You know, as humans, we do a lot to kind of isolate ourselves from a lot of the bad shit going on in this world. But it's things like that that kind of remind you that not everyone has it easy. People are truly struggling out there. And it's wise to take a moment and kind of think about it. And if you're not going through something like that or as serious as that, it's good to just take a minute and realize how nice you have it while other people are presumably have it way worse, like Rue. I mean, Rue is legitimately suffering. And if you find yourself in a situation like Rue, there is help. There is a way back. You don't have to suffer through it alone. There's resources. There's people to talk to. There's medication as well, but that can be tricky because the doses probably don't line up too well. And I think it's, for the majority, it's kind of like a feeling out process. We'll start you on 10 milligrams and we'll take you to 25 and whatever. And I'm assuming there's a lot of side effects. There's never a pharmaceutical that's just like, it cures your ills. And there's nothing to worry about on the other side. It's just like, it's either highly addictive or, you know, rots your organs or changes behavior. It is such a tangled mess of nonsense. But I guess if it helps with one thing and one thing becomes particularly worse, you just kind of pick your battles. That was kind of hard to watch, honestly. My reaction to it is, that is incredibly sad, and it pains me to know that people are actually going through stuff like that. Like, good grief. For me, at least, a lot of it is just experiencing it through entertainment, right? Hopefully you're not suffering with it or know somebody else that's suffering like Rue is, but if you do, stay strong. You might be the only reason they're hanging on, and that is extremely important. Continue to be the rock, and if somebody looks like they're having a bad time, just be nice to them. Just be nice to them. Doesn't hurt. Doesn't cost you anything. And it might help them. I'm not a licensed therapist or even remotely knowledgeable on this situation. But there's my 2 cents. Link below for the Patreon. Thank you for subscribing to the channel. And I shall see you on the next one. Thank you.